guys, it's Kat and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today is September 9th, it's a Wednesday. So for the most awaited videos. So for the most awaited video, here is the Katanungan. It is Katanungan, but Katanungan. Gets nyo na yun? Few weeks ago, you guys asked me questions anonymously through my curious cat. Anonymously means hindi ko alam na ikaw yung nagtanong. So, I have no idea kung sino yung nagtanong na question na yun. So, you can grab some snacks and, you know, chill. Kwentuhan lang tayo, tiro, getting to know me. So, I also told you guys that I will film the reaction while vlogging. But I realized na what if pare-parehas yung questions. So I just filmed my reaction while reading the questions. So here it is. Hey you guys, it's Kat and today is September 7. It is a Monday and I'm gonna compile the questions right now. Let's start. So this is my first time reading your questions. Start from the bottom to the top. So I'm back and I'm going to start answering the questions. So for the first question, hi Kat, if ever you meet someone na yes, perfect, your ideal type and everything, but there's one thing lang na hindi okay sa kanya, tapos yung hindi okay sa kanya, sobrang importante sa'yo nun, religion, ganyan. Would you let go or continue loving that person? Yay, thanks Kat. For me, I would rather let go siguro. Because I always remembered my mom saying na, sabi daw ng lola namin, never ever change your religion. So I was a lector, commentator, and a choir member sa simbahan. And I couldn't see myself na ibahin yun. I love God more than anything else. And I know He has better plans for me, better than mine. And I always, always, always know that the one will always draw me closer to God. Ano height mo? Cute lang. Miss mo na ba ang igig? Yes, of course. Miss niyo na rin ba ako? Hey. What is your greatest realization during this time of pandemic? I realized a lot of things. I realized that material things don't matter and what matters most is our health and that we will be able to survive this pandemic. I realized that everyone is affected sa kahit anong aspeto, sa kahit na sino tao sa mundo, lahat-lahat naging apektado. And I realized that you don't need to get validation from anyone, only yourself. What is your favorite book and why? So, meron si Strassinger, meron din si Bailey's. No joke lang. I really love to read The Catastrophic History of You and Me. It is my OG fave book talaga. And also the book of Kevin Kwan and also yung lahat ng books ni Nicholas Sparks. What makes you special? I think everyone is special in his or her own ways. We are all unique and different. That even if we are very similar, I know that there is something different, like the perspective, opinions, something like that. What is your life motto? Time is gold. Charot. So my motto in life is all for the glory of God. Kat isn't Kat without her family and also without God. Musician or a sporty guy? I think musician because musician ako eh. Who inspires you to become you now? My family. They inspire me to become the better version of myself. They are my power source, the mitochondria, and they really, really bring out the best in me. If you could only have one musical instrument in your life, what is it and why? Guitar, because I play guitar since I was 6 years old and it calms me whenever I play the guitar. What can you say about the situation or pandemic we are facing right now? With what's happening to the whole world, no one wanted it to happen. No one was even 100% prepared that this will even happen with our generation. Everyone is affected. Wala siyang pinalampas. Canceled plans happen. But always remember that canceled plans are not canceled dreams. That God has always a perfect timing for everything. And no matter how we planned our lives, if it is not God's perfect timing, then it will not really happen. All we have to do is to pray and pray. We need to have faith in God that all will be alright in His perfect time. Ano ang favorite movie mo? My favorite movie is A Walk to Remember. OG. OG favorite talaga yun. And also, The Crazy Rich Asians. Would you rather lose the ability to read or lose the ability to speak? Maybe I'd rather lose the ability to read because at least I still have the ability to listen and to speak. That's the most important thing, right? To listen to others and at the same time to speak out for yourself. Where do you want to travel and why? The number one on my bucket list is Rome because I really want to go there since I was a kid. Japan because I want to be under the shower of cherry blossoms and I want to go where Kimi no Na wa was filmed. South Korea, of course, the Iceland, the Northern Lights, and last but not the least, New York because of Friends. What is your favorite food? Lahat. Probably sinigang. Top 5 TLC family. For those of you who do not know, I'm a part of the school publishing before back when I was in college. It is the Luwisan Courier, TLC for short. Walang top 5, top 5. Lahat pantay-pantay. Love ko sila lahat. Favorite band? Tinatanong pa ba yan? Ben and Ben? Umaga na. Where are you now? Dito sa bahay ka, abat mo tinatanong kung nasan ako. Puppy love or true love? Great love. Favorite Bible verse? It is Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Quote, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." End quote. Best family moment? Every day. But the most highlight moment was when I passed the board exam last year. Because we are all awake that time and we all screamed when the results were out. What superpower do you dream of having? Maybe the power of flying so I can travel the whole world? Or to have the power to cure every single incurable disease in the whole world? What languages do you wish you could speak? I wish I could speak Spanish and French. Bonjour. What are your pet peeves? People chewing loud, kids stepping on the kneeler sa simbahan. People who doesn't have escalator etiquette. People who are always late because I'm always on time. Asking questions during the movie. Pwede naman after the movie, diba? What is your life mantra? One of the greatest goals in your life should not just for you to be merely happy, but to be genuinely happy. Happiness can be easily taken away from you, but being genuinely happy, it will never ever be taken away from you because genuine happiness is within yourself. Do you think that aliens exist? Yes, I believe that aliens do exist because there are 100 billion galaxies in the whole universe. Plus, watch the Unsolved Mysteries on Netflix. For you, who is more handsome, Kim Tae-yong or Jun Jung-kook? I really don't know them. I think Kim Tae-yong is more handsome. Milk tea or coffee? Milk tea. Bawal sa akin yung coffee. If you were given a chance or power to stop the time, what will you do? Stop it until I can, so I could spend more time with my parents because they are not getting any younger.
This is about the boomers and the millennial with today's generation. Do you think baby boomers played a negative or positive role with today's generation of growing cases of depression, and any advice to people who suffer from depression? Thank you. More vlogs to come.
Nosebleed ako says, it's really, really hard to grow up with today's generation. For me, all we need to have is understanding that we have a different situation, a different generation right now. Like for example, before, we don't have any internet connection, we don't have social media, but we have it right now. The more our generation is getting a comfortable life, the harder it is for us to understand each other. I really don't think of them as a positive or a negative, but what we need is understanding. And for those people who are suffering from depression, I know it's a really sensitive topic and depression is really a big word. I want you to know that you are not alone in this world. I'm not in the right position to tell exactly what to do. I know that there are organizations right now who are helping those who are in need of help. What's your most embarrassing moment nung high school? Apart from those embarrassing dancing and singing on stage, maybe the most embarrassing moment was when we were on a group and then andun yung crush ko. Tapos, I stepped on a poop. Yun, kailangan ko hugasan yung sapatos ko kasi umaamoy pa. Okay. What were the challenges you faced way back in high school, which was the most unforgettable one? I think the whole high school journey is merely us being so vulnerable. And I think all those challenges that I survived during high school were just challenges and they are part of it. Siguro yung pinakamahirap lang is the adjustment because I'm from Manila, and also yung adjustment to different kinds of people. Kung pagbibigyan ka ng pagkakataon na baguhin ang course mo nung college, ano ang iti-take mo? For those of you who do not know, I'm a registered medical technologist / laboratory scientist here in the Philippines. So, I have top 3 courses before. It is medical technology, mass comm, and fine arts major in interior design. Maybe I will take mass comm, but in our time kasi, in our batch, mass comm was removed in our school, so I think it's really God's plan. Hi ate, paano pumasa MTLE? Any tips? Hehe. I have a lot of tips, pamahiin, or any other related to the board exam on my vlog here. And I will link it on the description box. Why did you choose Medtech? Long story short, it is my highest during my NCAI, and I was attracted to the fact that Medtech isn't just merely Medtech. If others see it as tigakuha lang ng dugo, that's not just really what Medtech is. We are more than that. We help the doctors to diagnose the disease by having the results in the laboratory and many, many more. Any tips naman po sa mga aspiring medtechs dyan? Sa mga aspiring RMTs dyan, take a rest once in a while but never, ever, ever give up. Na kahit sabay-sabay na lahat ng mga requirements, ng mga lab manuals, ng mga practicals, ng mga exams, ng mga quizzes every day, you must never ever give up that dream of having those RMT. And don't also forget to enjoy your college life, but not too much. Learn how to balance your life. And if I did, I know you can too. What are your favorite highlights during college? There are really a lot. First is I was able to scratch one of my bucket list, and that is to sing in front of many people. It was during our socialization. I also joined literary contest, and of course, the Luisian Courier. I was able to meet amazing people that I will truly treasure for the rest of my life. And also the fun of balancing school. Nami-miss ko yung tunog ng bell during practicals and all the deadlines. means all the post and pre-test every day, lahat yun, lahat-lahat. And of course, the internship. It was full of life experiences talaga. Hindi lang siya yung basta sa school na mag-e-exam ka, na mag-aaral ka. But during the internship, andun na eh, kaharap mo na yung mga pasyente, kaharap mo na yung mga tao. And ang daming experiences when it comes to work na you should learn how to adjust with the environment and you should all treat the patients equally. And experiences are the biggest teachers in our lives. So ang daming nagtanong nito. Ayan. Magme-med ka pa if yes ang school.
The pressure is real.
But to answer that question, I'm the type of person who doesn't want to risk into something that I'm not completely sure about it and that my heart is not yet 100%. But I'm not closing any doors. So unfortunately, it rained and I will just cut this Q&A because umabot rin siya 100 plus questions, but I organized the topics para hindi siya magulo. So that's it for this vlog. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and click the notification bell button for you to get notified whenever I post another video. See you on the part 2. Ciao! Would you date an ex? What are your regrets? Ano-ano ang mga natutunan mo? What made you want to start a YouTube channel? Would you rather love or be loved?